So last video we spoke about the clever thoughts that we have that we grab onto and call ours. But today I wanted to talk to you about that swimming pool still that's got all the emotions, past experiences, future dreams all swimming around there. And I wanted to talk about the ones that we pick out sometimes that are negative. They don't serve us any good, and nor do they serve anyone around us any good too. It could be a past experience, some sort of worry, or any negativity, any thought or emotion that you label negative, I guess. And how we pick them and we hold them. And by holding them, it actually really prevents us from enjoying the oh so special moment of the very, very present moment where magic can happen. So I wanted to share with you a strategy that has been developing for over a year now that I've been using. So when I would pick out one of these thoughts, emotions, past experiences, future worry, and I would hold on to it, I would then stop and figure out why I'm thinking about this. Can I do anything about it? And what is the source of this thought or thing that's popped up in my mind? And I would try and figure it out like that. And then I would, this is where it comes in, then I would just blow it away. And that really helped me a lot. And that even helped with emotions that I felt in certain situations too. That I would just blow it away. But then as I kept doing this, it progressed more. And I, instead of figuring it out and then blowing it away, I would figure it out and then blow love into it. And by blowing love into it, then it was almost like I was blowing love to a part of myself that was unhappy or was not fulfilled, it was empty. And by doing that, it showed myself a lot more love, and it also was able to release that part and show forgiveness to myself. And if it was to do with maybe an argument you may have had with a friend or family member, or a situation where you wish you had have done this or said this, then it was like you were, like I was blowing love into that and forgiving that part of myself, and forgiving and showing love and compassion to a person that I may have had an argument with. And by doing this, I've really benefited from it. And the more you do it, the less you need to do it, because you seem to show yourself more love. So some love to you, and I am going to get back to reading this book.